Welcome to EU Droneport. In this video, I will explain the main points you need to have to start flying a drone. Drones have become increasingly popular in recent years, and their use has expanded to many fields, from package delivery to photography and video. However, with the increase in drone popularity, there have also been increasing concerns about safety and privacy. To ensure safety, the European Union has introduced a registration requirement for all drone pilots. Starting from January 1, 2021, all individuals or companies who want to fly drones must register as a UAS operator in the country where they reside. This registration is valid throughout the European Union and allows pilots to legally and safely operate their drones in European airspace. The registration process is simple and can be done online. Users or companies must provide basic information about themselves, such as their name, address, and contact details. In addition, they must agree to comply with all European regulations and standards on drone flight. To find the UAS operator registration page in your country, we recommend that you access our article, How to Fly Drones in the EU. Registration as a UAS operator is mandatory for all pilots, including those who use drones for commercial or recreational purposes. However, there are some cases where operator registration is not required, although they are very exceptional. After registering as a UAS operator, you will receive a certificate with your name and data, as well as a registration number that will be used to identify you as a drone operator and request permits. Training is essential for drone pilots and is now mandatory to fly almost all UAS. However, the required training will depend on the type of drone to be flown and the scenario in which it is used. For example, the training required to fly a 250-gram drone will be different from that required for a 900-gram or 15-kilogram drone, and it will also be different if it is flown in the city or in an open space. Each scenario and type of drone will determine the training required for the pilot. If you do not know in which category you will fly the drone, you can consult our article on open category and specific category. Drone training for the open category is as follows. Drones under 250 grams, subcategories A1 and A3 do not require training. Knowing the manufacturer's instructions is enough to operate these drones in the open category. Drones over 250 grams for subcategories A1 and A3 require the A1-A3 training, which can commonly be done online and includes both theory and an exam. We can use these drones in open category, A1 up to 900 grams, and in A3 up to 25 kilograms. Drones over 900 grams for subcategory A2 also require A2 training if they will be operated in urban environments, close to people or buildings. The specific category training is primarily designed for the standard scenarios STS-01 and STS-02. During the transitional period, each member state has defined its own curriculum and method of delivering the training, adapting it to its own national scenario versions. Now that we are registered as an operator and have completed the training, all that's left is to go flying. To do this, it's important to know and follow the air rules. At this point, it's very important to understand that there are European-level regulations for flying drones, but these delegate certain points to national regulations. Additionally, during the transitional period, in some cases, national regulations may still have considerable weight, defining quite different regulations between member states. If you need help setting up your drone operator, training, or any other process or permit, do not hesitate to consult our services. For more information, visit eudroneport.com or click the link in the description. Safe flights.